Example of design of an active circuit determination of the DC bias. We first open advanced design system. Then we create a new workspace. We need then to add RF transistors vendor kit and S parameter vendor kit. To do that, we need to unzip these two packages. After unzipping, we can add them to our workspace. Now we start to draw the circuit. First, we search for the transistor by typing 41411 in the search panel and the select PB_HP_AT41411_1992110101. Then we add iProbe, VDC, IDC, and ground. We then add variables VCE equals 0 volts and IBB equals 0 ampere. Then we add parameter sweep simulation by typing sweep in the search panel, and also we will add DC simulation. And then we set properties according to the instructions of the course. Finally, we click on the Run button, and then in the open window we can add plots of transistor current. In the next section of the lab, we will work on the design of the bias circuit of the transistor at the desired operating point. Now we start to draw the circuit. First, we search for the transistor by typing 41411 in the search panel and the select PB_HP_AT41411_1992101. Then we add I-probe, VDC, IDC, and ground. We also need to add RB1, RB2, and RC1 to the circuit. We used a constant 10 volts DC bias voltage. And we need to determine RB1, RB2, and RC1 to achieve IC equals 10 mA and VCE equals 8 volts. We use optimization in ADS to determine the values of resistors by defining the goals that we want. We have two goals that we want to achieve. One is IC equals 10 mA, and the other is VCE equals 8 volts. We will add these goals to the simulation. We add also optimization by searching Optim in the search panel. And finally, we will add DC simulation. We set properties according to the course instructions. In the Simulate panel, we choose Simulate Variable Setup, and in the Open window, we choose Optimization, and we select RB1, RB2, and RC1 as optimization variables. Then we set the ranges of these variables according to the course instructions. Finally, we click on the Run button, and in the Open window we add plots and a table of transistor current and voltage. We then click on the Optimize button, and wait until optimization finishes, then in the Open window, and also in the Optimization window, we can see that both goals are achieved and we can update the design with the values of the optimized resistors. In the next section of the lab, we will focus on the stability study of the design. First, we start drawing the circuit by searching 41411 in the search panel and then selecting SP_HP_AT41411_1_1992120. This is a compact model of the transistor and the bias circuit, which we optimized in the previous section by using optimization. As we can see, the bias voltage and current are at the same operating point that we optimized. Then we will add ports by searching term in the search panel. We then add S-parameter simulation. We also add options to the simulation to simulate the problem at the temperature and conditions we need. Then to study the circuit stability, we add stab fact, stab mean, S underscore stab circle, and L underscore stab circle analysis to the simulation, and we set all properties the same as course instruction. Finally, we click on the Run button, and in the open window we plot the K and B1 factors. As we can see, we achieved the same results as course instruction. The device is unconditionally stable for frequencies above 1.4 GHz. In the next section, we add an output stabilizing circuit to our device. We can copy the same circuit from the previous analysis and only add the stabilizing circuit to the output, and then by running the simulation we can see that now the device is unconditionally stable at all frequencies. The next section, we want to plot constant noise figure circles at 1 GHz. We can copy the same circuit from the previous analysis and add the NS circle analysis to the problem. We set all properties according to course instructions and we click the Run button. We can see that our results are the same as the instructions. The next section is about designing the input circuit. We start drawing the circuit by adding ports, inductor L, and S1P underscore equation. We add variables, S parameter simulation, and parameter sweep according to the instructions. We then run the circuit and we can see that for which value of L for induction, we have the best return loss. It is worth noting that S1P underscore equation is the input impedance of the transistor at the optimum operating point which we optimized in the previous sections. The next section is almost the same as the previous one. We can copy the circuit, add the capacitor, and then apply necessary changes. We then run the problem and see for which value of C we have the best return loss. In the next sections, we do the same analysis for the output impedance and use the parameter sweep to obtain the best L for the inductor and the best C for the capacitor to have minimum return loss. In the last section of the lab, we combine all the parts we designed and draw the complete circuit to analyze the total return loss, noise, and gain of the amplifier. We set all of the properties according to the instructions, then we'll run the simulation and plot desired parameters, and we can see that we achieve the same as the instruction.